This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In United States law, a federal enclave is a parcel of federal property within a state that is under the special maritime and territorial jurisdiction of the United States. As of 1960, the latest comprehensive inquiry, 7% of federal property had enclave status, of which 4%, almost all in Alaska and Hawaii, was under concurrent state jurisdiction. The remaining 3%, on which some state laws do not apply, is scattered almost at random throughout the United States. In 1960, there were about 5,000 enclaves, with about 1 million people living on them. These numbers would undoubtedly be lower today because many of these areas were military bases that have been closed and transferred out of federal ownership since late 1950s. It has been an official federal policy that the states should have full concurrent jurisdiction on all federal enclaves, an approach endorsed by legal experts. Contents 1. Relation to other subdivisions. 2. History. 21. Early developments. 22. 1885, cession and reservation as alternatives. 23. International law rule. 24. After 1900, Congress begins to authorize state laws. 25. 1937, Supreme Court allows states to reserve jurisdiction. 26. February 1, 1940, Congress discourages new enclaves. 27. Post-World War II, courts apply state laws without retrocession. 28. 1953, abolishment of the extraterritoriality doctrine. 29. 1956, Congress can authorize state law without retrocession. 210-1956, concurrent jurisdiction. 211-1970, friction not fiction, reiterated. 3. Current legal status. 31. State laws enforceable. 32. State laws not enforceable. 33. Effect of Mississippi Tax I Opinion. 34. Recent developments in national forests. 4. Notes. 5. References. Relation to other subdivisions. Since the 1953 Howard v. Commissioners case, the Supreme Court has held that the collection of city and state taxes from federal enclave residents is permissible, establishing the friction not fiction doctrine. Residents of federal enclaves have the right to vote in the elections of the state in which the federal enclave is situated. This is based on the friction not fiction doctrine, and was challenged by a Maryland law in 1968. The subject of the case, Evans v. Corman. The case was decided by the Supreme Court in 1970, and overruled the Maryland law, upholding the voting rights of enclave residents and establishing that they should be regarded as residents of the state in question. Federal enclaves are to be distinguished from federal territories and possessions administered under Article 4, Section 3, Clause 2, which once included all the territory that has since become states, and still includes insular territories like Puerto Rico, the United States Virgin Islands, Guam, American Samoa, and a few others. Historically, the Congress has not exercised a full array of state-like powers over such territories, but tried to organize them into self-governing entities, as was done with the Northwest Ordinance and the Southwest Ordinance. History. Early developments. The first federal enclaves were created by the same clause of the Constitution that created the District of Columbia. That clause provides for the United States to exercise exclusive legislation over the new seat of government and like authority over all places purchased by the consent of the legislature of the state in which the same shall be, for the erection of forts, magazines, arsenals, dock yards, and other needful buildings. As a result of the enclave clause, whenever the state government consented to the purchase of property by the federal government for a needful building, the United States obtained exclusive legislative jurisdiction over that parcel of property. In 1841, the Congress enacted a general law requiring state consent for all federal building projects. Moreover, the Attorneys General of the United States ruled that, in consenting to purchase, the states could reserve no jurisdiction except for the service of criminal and civil process. 1885, cession and reservation as alternatives. In 1885, the Supreme Court ruled that there were two additional ways in which the United States could acquire federal enclaves. One, the states could cede legislative jurisdiction to the United States, and two, the United States could reserve legislative jurisdiction at the time of statehood. The Supreme Court added that these cessions and reservations were not limited to enclave clause needful building purposes because state laws did not apply to federal enclaves. Congress provided a few basic criminal laws in the Federal Crimes Act of 1790, and later adopted a series of assimilative crimes acts, federalizing each state's crimes by making making them prosecutable in federal courts. International law rule. Congress provided no civil laws to govern these enclaves, so in 1885, the Supreme Court held that the international law rule applied. That rule provides that when a territory is transferred from one government to another, such as when a federal enclave is ceded, laws for the protection of private rights continue in force until abrogated or changed by the new government under the doctrine of extraterritoriality. A federal enclave was treated as a state within a state until 1953, and therefore enclave residents were not residents of the state. They could not vote in state elections, attend public schools, obtain a divorce in state courts, or call upon state law enforcement officers to protect them from criminals. After 1900, Congress begins to authorize state laws. Nevertheless, Congress gradually authorized the enforcement of some state laws on federal enclaves. Thus, in 1928, Congress made applicable to federal enclaves state laws governing wrongful death and personal injuries, and in the late 1930s Congress authorized states to apply their state taxes on fuel, income, sales and use the Buck Act, and state laws governing workers' compensation and unemployment insurance. 1937, Supreme Court allows states to reserve jurisdiction. In 1937, because of concern over the lack of state law on federal enclaves, the Supreme Court held that the states could reserve some jurisdiction to themselves in consenting to federal legislative jurisdiction. In response, the states began to amend their consent and session statutes to reserve state jurisdiction, including the power to tax enclave residents to distinguish earlier exclusive jurisdiction enclaves from those acquired after the state amendments. The newer enclaves were labeled partial jurisdiction, and the label concurrent was given to enclaves over which the state had full jurisdiction. Finally, non-enclave federal property was called proprietorial. February 1, 1940, Congress discourages new enclaves effective February 1, 1940. Congress repealed the 1841 statute requiring state consent to federal purchases, and instead said that the acquisition of federal property after that date would no longer result in the transfer of jurisdiction to the United States unless the head of the federal agency in charge of the property filed a notice with the state governor accepting whatever jurisdiction was offered by the state. However, during World War II, the United States acquired many new military installations, and the Secretary of War sent numerous letters to state governors accepting whatever jurisdiction the state offered, often without describing the location or boundaries of these military installations. Post-World War II, courts apply state laws without retrocession. After World War II, the states began to apply state laws to enclave residents without waiting for Congress to act. Thus, in 1952, a California court gave enclave residents the right to vote in state elections, rejecting the extraterritoriality doctrine, and holding that enclave residents were residents of the state. In 1970, the Supreme Court agreed, in Evans v. Corman, holding that all enclave residents have a right to vote in state elections. In 1950, without addressing the jurisdictional issue directly, Congress passed legislation providing federal financial aid to schools in localities impacted by federal facilities. 6 years later, in 1956, the government reported that because of this federal aid, not a single child is being denied the right to a public school education because of his residence on a federal enclave. Earlier, courts in Kansas, Georgia, and New Mexico held they had no jurisdiction to grant divorces to residents of federal enclaves, but after each state amended its divorce statutes to permit such divorces, court decisions in each state upheld the validity of these statutes. Today, every state treats enclave residents as residents of the state for purposes of divorce proceedings. 1953, abolishment of the extraterritoriality doctrine. The extraterritoriality doctrine was abolished by the Supreme Court in 1953 in Howard v. Commissioners. The city of Louisville, Kentucky, had annexed a federal enclave into its city limits, thereby allowing the collection of city taxes from enclave residents under the Buck Act. Residents of the enclave argued that the annexation was improper because the federal enclave ceased to be a part of Kentucky when the United States assumed exclusive jurisdiction over it. The Supreme Court rejected the argument, holding that the annexation did not interfere with federal functions, and what was important was friction, not fiction. A change of municipal boundaries did not interfere in the least with the jurisdiction of the United States within the area or with its use or disposition of the property. The fiction of a state within a state can have no validity to prevent the state from exercising its power over the federal area within. its boundaries, so long as there is no interference with the jurisdiction asserted by the federal government. The sovereign rights in this dual relationship are not antagonistic. Accommodation and cooperation are their aim. It is friction, not fiction, to which we must give heed. 1956, Congress can authorize state law without retrocession. In 1956, 3 years after Howard v. Commissioners, the Supreme Court in Offutt Housing Co. v. Sarpy County upheld Congress's power to authorize the application of state laws to federal enclaves without a relinquishment of jurisdiction. In affirming the state's right to tax a private builder of military housing, the Supreme Court emphasized that the Congress's authorization for state taxation on enclave property was not a retrocession. We do not hold that Congress has relinquished this power over these areas. We hold only that Congress, in the exercise of this power, has permitted such state taxation as is involved in the present case. 1956, concurrent jurisdiction. Federal government reports in 1956 and 1957 concluded that the states should have full concurrent jurisdiction on all federal enclaves. In 1969, the Public Land Law Review Commission published a report on developments since the 1956 and 1957 reports, observing that those reports had been successful in changing federal agency policy and limiting further acquisition of federal enclaves. The 1969 report said that in 1960, there were about 5,000 enclaves with about 1 million people living on them. These numbers have never been updated, but they would certainly be lower today, because many military bases have been closed, and jurisdiction over most off-base housing areas has been transferred to the states. 1970, friction not fiction, reiterated in 1970, a year after the 1969 report, the Supreme Court in Evans v. Cornman unanimously held that enclave residents have a right to vote in state elections. In reaching this result, Evans reiterated the friction not fiction doctrine of Howard v. Commissioners, and reaffirmed that enclave residents should be regarded as residents of the state. Evans also unanimously reaffirmed the holding in Offutt Housing that Congress could give the states jurisdiction without relinquishing enclave status. The court relied in part on the fact that Congress had authorized the states to enforce many state laws on federal enclaves. Some criminal laws have also been authorized by Congress to apply on federal enclaves, including immigrant stations and Job Corps centers. In addition, the state's power to enforce their tax laws on federal enclaves necessarily includes the power to prosecute enclave residents criminally for violating those laws. Under Evans, Congress has the power, if it chooses, to authorize the enforcement of all state laws on federal enclaves. It need not retrocede or relinquish federal jurisdiction. Instead, it can, to use Offutt Housing's language, simply permit all state laws to apply to all federal property regardless of federal enclave status. In addition, the friction not fiction doctrine indicates that the courts can approve the application state laws to federal enclaves to the same extent that they apply to the other 97% of federal lands, i.e., subject only to the limitations of the Supremacy Clause with regard to the state's ability unilaterally to apply their laws on federal enclaves. Evans noted that enclave residents are required to register their automobiles in Maryland and obtain driver's permits and license plates from the state. They are subject to the process and jurisdiction of state courts. They themselves can resort to those courts in divorce and child adoption proceedings, and they send their children to Maryland public schools. Current legal status: state laws enforceable. In addition to these laws mentioned by Evans, such court-applied laws include state probate laws, public welfare laws, laws relating to mentally ill persons, juvenile delinquency, protection of abused and neglected children, and domestic violence restraining orders. State laws not enforceable. Nevertheless, there are other cases which hold that some state laws do not apply on enclaves, including most state criminal laws, liquor laws, personal property taxes, some utility regulations, human rights laws, anti-discrimination laws, racial discrimination laws, whistleblower laws, state occupational safety and health OSHA laws, wage and hour laws, and right to work laws. Effect of Mississippi tax. I opinion: many of these decisions are based on the extraterritoriality doctrine that was abolished by Howard and Evans. They often rely on dicta in the Supreme Court's 1973 Mississippi tax. I opinion United States v. State Tax Commission of Mississippi, which ignored Howard and Evans and instead favorably quoted the district court's assertion that enclaves are foreign land and federal islands which no longer constitute any part of Mississippi nor function under its control. Nevertheless, Mississippi Tax I's holding, that the 21st Amendment did not authorize a state markup on liquor, made it unnecessary to discuss enclave jurisdiction, so the foreign lands language was quite unnecessary. On the other hand, in 1990, the Supreme Court treated Mississippi Tax I as an enclave case, citing it for the proposition that a state has no authority to regulate a transaction between an out-of-state liquor supplier and a federal military base under exclusive federal jurisdiction. Still, no court has suggested that Mississippi Tax I change the friction not fiction rule of Howard and Evans. The Texas Court of Appeals noted the conflict and followed the friction not fiction rule in holding that the federal enclave at Red River Army Depot was part of Texas for state tax purposes in upholding a state tax on aircraft parts. The court distinguished Mississippi Tax I on the ground that, unlike the liquor markup in that case, in Avial Services, Inc. v. Tarrant Appraisal Dist, here was no interference with federal jurisdiction by the taxing entities, hence, no friction. Therefore, we will not apply the fiction that the depot was a foreign country or a sister state to deem that the aviation parts were shipped by Avial outside the state when they were shipped to a location in Bowie County near Texarkana, within the geographic limits of Texas. Similarly, the California Court of Appeal has acknowledged Mississippi Tax I's statements about the Enclave Clause with regard to state liquor regulations, but nevertheless relied on Howard and Evans to hold that the Enclave Clause did not prevent the application of state laws protecting dependent children. Recent developments in national forests: for many years, it was believed that the vast majority of national forests were not federal enclaves. However, federal appeals courts in North Carolina, Michigan, and Oklahoma have recently ruled that session statutes in each of those states ceded concurrent jurisdiction over national forest lands acquired by the United States before February 1, 1940. Depending on the wording of session statutes in other states, these cases may mean that the United States has considerable concurrent enclave jurisdiction in national forests. Notes: 18 U.S.C. Section 73C, United States Department of Justice Criminal Resource Manual, Section 1630 AB, Federal Legislative Jurisdiction, Report Washington, D.C., Public Land Law Review Commission, Land and Natural Resources Division, U.S. Department of Justice, 1969, retrieved 3 November 2011. Carat ABID, at 146 Carat U.S. Report of the INTERDEPARTMENTAL Committee for the Study of Jurisdiction over Federal Areas Within the States, Part 1, The Facts and Committee Recommendations, 1956. Hereafter, 1956 Report, at 70 Carat Roger W. Haynes, Jr., Federal Enclave Law Atlas, Bookscom 2011, at 9, 213, Stephen E. Caslin and Gregory O. Block, Exclusive Federal Legislative Jurisdiction, Get Rid of It, 154 Mill L. Rev. 113-1997, David E. Engdahl, State and Federal Power Over Federal Property, 18 Aries L. Rev. 283-336, and 228 1976, No Extensive Patchwork of Nationalized Acreages Created Here and There Out of the Territory of the States, Even with State Consent, Could Have Been Intended, Carat Howard v. Commissioners, 344 U.S. 624, 626, 73 SCT 465, 97 Led 617-1953 Carat AB Evans v. Kornman, 398 U.S. 419, 422, 90 SCT 1752, 26 Led 2D 370-1970 Carat United States Constitution, Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17 Enclave Clause Carat Section 355 of the Revised Statutes of the United States Carat U.S. Report of the INTERDEPARTMENTAL Committee for the Study of Jurisdiction over Federal Areas Within the States, Part 2, A Text of the Law of Legislative Jurisdiction 1957 Hereafter 1957 Report at 5 Carat Fort Leavenworth R. Coe v. Lowe, 114 U.S. 525, 531, 5 SCT 995, 29 Led 264-1885 Carat The Current Assimilative Crimes Act as at 18 U.S.C. Section 13 Carat Chicago, Rock Island. Carat AB 4 U.S.C. Section 105-108, enacted in 1940 and known as the Buck Act. Carat 40 U.S.C. Section 290, enacted in 1936 to the power of 26 U.S.C. Section 3305d, enacted in 1939. Carat James v. Dravo Contracting Co., 302 U.S. 134, 148, 58 SCT 208, 82 Led 155-1000 1937 to the power of 1957 report, Supra Note 6 at 11. The February 1, 1940 law was codified in three titles of the United States Code as 33 U.S.C. Section 733, 40 U.S.C. Section 255, and 50 U.S.C. Section 175 in 2002. The jurisdictional part of the statute was amended and recodified as 40 U.S.C. Section 3112(c), e.g., General Dynamics Land Systems, Inc. v. Tracy, 83 Ohio Street 3D 500, 700 NE 2D 1242, 1244-45 Ohio SCT 1998 ruling that even though the 1943 and 1945 letters from the Secretary of War did not identify specific properties, they were sufficient to accept jurisdiction. 1957 report, Supra Note 6 at 7-8. Arapajalu v. McMenamin, 113 Cal App 2D 284, 249 P2D 318-1952. Evans v. Kornman, 398 U.S. 4 1990, SCT 1752, 26 Led 2D 371970 to the power of 20 U.S.C. Sections 236 at SEQ. 1956 report, Supra Note 2 at 55. Craig v. Craig, 143 Kansas 6-24-56, P464-1936, Darby v. Darby, 195 GA 769, 25 SE 2D 685-1943, Crownover v. Crownover, 58 NM 597, 274 P 2D 127-1954. Haynes, Supra Note 3 at 42. Howard v. Commissioners, 344 U.S. 6-24-73, SCT 465, 97 Led 617-1953. ID, 344 U.S. at 626. Offutt Housing Co. v. Sarpy County, 351 U.S. 253, 260-261, 76 SCT 814, 100 Led 1151-1956 to the power of 1956 report, Supra Note 3 at 70, 1957 report, Supra Note 6 at V. 1969 report, Supra Note 2 at 52. Evans, 398 U.S. at 424, quoting Offutt Housing Co. v. Sarpy County, 351 U.S. 253, 260-261, 76 SCT 814, 100 Led 1151-1956. Evans, 398 U.S. at 425 to the power of 8 U.S.C. Section 1358 to the power of 29 U.S.C. Section 1705d, originally codified at 29 U.S.C. Section 937d. See Philadelphia v. Konopacki, 2 Pascals d. Pa Com Place 1975 holding that Philadelphia could enforce a $300 fine for non-payment of city tax from a resident of a federal enclave, regardless of whether the fine was characterized as criminal or quasi-criminal. C. Haynes, Supra Note 3 at 9, 102-103, 213 ID at 9, 107, 213 Evans, 398 U.S. at 424 to the power of 1957 report, Supra Note 16 at 235, N57. Board v. Donahoe, 344 Colo 321, 356 P2D 267-1960. Board v. McCorkle, 98 NJ Super 451, 237 A2D 640-1968. Matter of Charles B., 196 MISC 2D 374, 765 NYS 2D 191 2003. State v. Debbie F., 120 NM 665, 905 P2D 205-1995. Cobb v. Cobb, 406 Massachusetts 21545, Northeast 2D 1161-1989. AB United States v. State Tax Com of Mississippi, 412 U.S. 363, 378, 93 SCT 2183, 2000 2,192, 37 lead 2D 1973 carat Humble Pipe Line Co. V. Wagoner, 376 US 36984, SCT 857, 11 lead 2D 782 1964 carat Black Hills Power and Light Co. V. Weinberger, 808 F 2D 665/8, CIR 1987. Carat Huda v. Brookhaven Nat Laboratory, 659 FSUPP 2D 382 ed NY 2009 Carat Osborne v. Morrison Knudsen Corp., 962 F SUP 1206 ed MO 1997 Age discrimination, Miller v. Wackenhut Services, 808 FSUPP 697, 700 WDM 1992 Anti-discrimination laws Carat Taylor v. Lockheed Martin Corp., 78 8 Calip 4th 472, 482, 92 Cal RPTR 2D 873 2000 Carat Stiefel v. Bechtel Corp., 497 FSUPP 2D 1138 SD Cal 2007 Stiefel I Carat Department of Labor and Industry v. Dirt Services, Inc., 326 FSUPP 2D 1305, 1312 N 6 MD AL 2004 Citing Howard v. Commissioners, 344 U.S. 624, 626, 73 SCT 465, 97 LED 617-1953 Carat C Discussion in Haynes, Supra Note 3 at 104-106 Carat North Dakota v. United States, 495 U.S. 420 23110, SCT 1986, 109 LED 2D 420-1990 Carat Avial Services, Inc. v. Tarrant Appraisal Dist, 300 SW 3D 441, 449 TEXIP 2009 Carat Avial Services, 300 SW 3D at 449 Carat In Re Terry Y, 101 Calip 3D 178, 161 Cal RPTR 452, 45 53-1980 Carat C, E.G., 1957 Report, Supra Note 6, at 114 Carat United States v. Raffield, 82 F 3D 611 4th, CIR 1996 North Carolina, United States v. Gabrion, 517 F 3D 839 6th, CIR 2008 Michigan, United States v. Fields, 516 F 3D 923 10th Circle 2008, Oklahoma Carat C discussion, with particular reference to California and Missouri statutes in Haynes, Supra Note 3, at 134-154 references a dissertation on the nature and extent of the jurisdiction of the courts of the United States, Peter Stephen DuPonceau 1824. Conflict of Criminal Laws, Edward S. Stimson 1936 Foundation Press v.E. United States. Mexican-American War Civil War Reconstruction Era Indian Wars Gilded Age Progressive Era African-American Civil Rights Movement 1865-1895. Korean War Space Race Civil Rights Movement Feminist Movement Vietnam War Post-Cold War 1991 Present War on Terror War in Afghanistan Iraq War Timeline of Modern American Conservatism by Topic Demographic Discoveries Economic Debt Ceiling Inventions Before 1890-1945 1946-91 After 1991 Military Postal Technological and Industrial Geography Territory States Territories Counties Cities, Towns, and Villages Earthquakes Extreme Points Islands Mountains Peaks Ranges Appalachian Rocky National Park Service National Parks Regions East Coast West Coast Great Plains Gulf Mid-Atlantic Midwestern New England Pacific Central Eastern Northern Northeastern Northwestern Southern Southeastern Southwestern Western Rivers Colorado Columbia Mississippi Missouri Ohio Rio Grande Time Water Supply and Sanitation Politics Federal Executive President Executive Office Cabinet Civil Service Independent Agencies Law Enforcement Public Policy Legislature Congress Senate Vice President President Pro Tempore House of Representatives Speaker Judiciary Federal Judiciary Supreme Court Courts of Appeals District Courts Law Constitution Federalism Preemption Separation of Powers Bill of Rights Civil Liberties Code of Federal Regulations Federal Reporter United States Code United States Reports Intelligence Central Intelligence Agency Defense Intelligence Agency Federal Bureau of Investigation National Geospatial Intelligence Agency National Reconnaissance Office National Security Agency Office of the Director of National Intelligence Uniformed Armed Forces Army Marine Corps Navy Air Force Coast Guard National Guard NOAA Corps Public Health Service Corps Political Divisions List of States and Territories of the United States States Territories Federal District Native American Autonomous Administrative Divisions United States Minor Outlying Islands Associated States Local Government in the United States Federal Enclave Elections Electoral College Foreign Policy Foreign Relations Ideologies Parties Democratic Republican Third Parties 51st State Political Status of Puerto Rico District of Columbia Statehood Movement Red States and Blue States Purple America Scandal State Governments Governor State Legislature State Court Uncle Sam Economy Agriculture Banking Communications Companies by State Dollar Currency Energy Exports Federal Budget Federal Reserve System Financial Position Insurance Labor Unions Mining Public Debt Social Welfare Programs Taxation Tourism Trade Transportation Unemployment Wall Street Society Culture Americana Architecture Art Cinema Crime Cuisine Dance Demographics Education Family Structure Fashion Flag Folklore Health Care Health Insurance Incarceration Languages American English Indigenous Languages ASL Black American Sign Language HSL Plains Sign Talk Arabic Chinese French German Italian Russian Spanish Literature Media Music Names People Philosophy Public Holidays Radio Religion Sports Television Theater Social Class Affluence American Dream Educational Attainment Homelessness Home Ownership Household Income Income Inequality Middle Class Personal Income Poverty Professional and Working Class Conflict Smoking Standard of Living Wealth Issues Abortion Affirmative Action Ages of Consent Anti-Americanism Capital Punishment Criticism of Government Discrimination Drug Policy Energy Policy Environmental Movement Exceptionalism List of Vetoes Exercised by the U.S. Government in the UN Security Council Gun Politics Health Care Reform Human Rights Hunger Immigration Illegal International Rankings Islamophobia LGBT Rights Same-sex Marriage Nationalism Obesity Racism Separation of Church and State Terrorism Outline Index Book Category Portal VE Political Divisions of the United States States Alabama Alaska Arizona Arkansas California Colorado Connecticut Delaware Florida Georgia Hawaii Idaho Illinois Indiana Iowa Kansas Kentucky Louisiana Maine Maryland Massachusetts